Welcome to Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz.
Like me, help you groom. So follow your dreams and you will see. You can dream big just like me.
Along with Elijah, our music coordinator. We're back with the brand new Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz show. And in case you forgot, Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz is about amazing kids and the things they do. It's a show about encouraging and empowering kids to pursue their dreams and to be the best that they can be.
Hello, I'm attorney Matt Van Cleve with the Pickler Law Firm. As an attorney, I represent kids and organizations throughout Memphis and Shelby County. One organization that I'm proud to represent is Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz. Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz is a great organization that highlights the kids of the Memphis area and the great things they do. And it has a show that encourages and empowers kids to follow their dreams and be the best they can be. Is that right, guys?
Yeah, definitely.
So I'd like to invite our city leaders, school officials, and the entire Memphis and Shelby County community to join me in support of Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz and help Memphis become a city of choice. This is Matt Van Cleve with the Pickler Law Firm, supporting the youth of our city and Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz.
This segment of our show is called Kids Empowering the Community. This will give kids an opportunity to come on the KDPT show and talk about ways we can empower the community. We want to encourage kids to set goals, pursue their dreams, and be the best they can be. Welcome to the Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz show. Hi, I'm Cleveland, your host.
And I'm Adam Miles, guitarist.
We have a very interesting show lined up for you kids today.
Yes, we do. We'll be learning how to become Core Fire Commandos.
Kids, we are at the Kroc Center, located in the Midtown area of Memphis, Tennessee. The Kroc Center offers great programs for the entire family. Let's go join Mr. Cobbs and his entire staff. Joining us on the set today are the Core Fire coaches from the Core Fire Training Zone. Thank you for being a part of the Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz show.
Absolutely, it's our pleasure, no problem.
Yeah, thank you.
Can you introduce yourselves?
Absolutely, my name is Jacob.
I'm Alan McClang.
And my name is Elise Ingram, and we're all Core Fire Training coaches.
The Core Fire Training Zone is such an interesting place. I understand the center opened in February 2013, and during the first 5 months, you had 13,000 people come through?
That's right, and since February, all 13,000 of those people have had the privilege of going through our unique rescue training event that allows people of all ages, even senior citizens and corporations, as well as school groups, to participate in a really unique team-building opportunity.
Can you tell the parents and kids out there about the Core Fire Training Zone?
Absolutely. Again, the Core Fire Training Zone, we do rescue training in here. It's a really fun event that really creates a fun, fired up atmosphere for people to do team training in. We've had all kinds of groups come through, and you go through different challenges that you're going to learn different skills in that you'll need as a Core Fire Commando. But even a lot of times during rescue training, you'll actually be deployed on a real Core Fire Commando mission where you'll have to solve a real world problem. And that's a really exciting event for people of all ages.
Cool. Who came up with the idea for the Core Fire Training Zone?
Ty Cobb came up with this idea over a decade ago, and we've had the privilege of being able to run this location here in Midtown at the Kroc, as well as a location out in Cordova.
Cool. Since we both are musicians, can you tell us about the Garage Band?
Sure. We've got a really fun program for kids who want to be performers that don't really have a lot of experience performing music. And we have this program where we're doing a rescue training event, and different folks can come in and they can perform just one song. If they're just a beginning musician, we'll open a garage door out there in the front, close to our turf, and they'll be able to perform that song and close the garage door, and then allow another participant to perform their song.
Cool. So what is the role of a core fire coach?
A core fire coach acts mainly as a facilitator to help the people on the team figure out what they need to do to solve the challenge that they come up against during rescue training.
Yeah, you know, and our main job as a core fire coach is really just to make sure everyone's having a lot of fun and working together as a team, because, you know, that is something we reinforce the entire time, is that, you know, you're having a lot of enthusiasm, kind of going crazy, and just working together, because that's the most important thing at the end of the day.
And we have to continue to have positivity with the kids. Can't ever be negative with the kids. You got to stay positive. And the more positive you are, the more they're intrigued to the events that we're doing. And we have a lot of fun with them.
So how do you even become a coach?
We have a variety of high school and college students that come in to coach with us. And even a lot of the volunteers from the community also come and they act as coaches while they're working with us.
Cool. You provide core fire leadership training for kids?
That's right. Core fire leadership training is a really exciting opportunity. It's a part of our K-5 collaboration, which is an initiative that gets the fifth graders that feed into the four largest high schools in Memphis into core fire leadership training, which is an event that teaches them really important skills that they'll carry even to their college careers and beyond. It teaches them the importance of guiding vision, which gives them a roadmap to follow their dreams. And then it teaches them the importance of passion following that, which gives them the motivation to pursue that vision. And then finally, we teach them the importance of integrity and why being a person of good character is the mark of true success.
Is there a specific age group you target?
It is. We specifically go, we want fifth graders to be involved in our program specifically because we're able to give them these skills before they even enter middle and high school, which really gives them a head start ahead of a lot of their peers.
Right.
Yeah, definitely. You know, fifth grade is such an important age because when you go into middle school and you go into high school, you know, that's when you really encounter a lot of peer pressure and tough decisions to make. And hopefully we want our program to encourage, you know, positive reinforcement and learning good skill sets now before they even enter into those situations.
What are the core things you are trying to teach them through this program?
We really try to hit on those three things: guiding vision, passion, and integrity. And the reason that we try to emphasize those in our program is because really it all boils down to that. It boils down to having a vision that you want to go after, having the passion to go after it, and then having the character to make the right decisions as you go through that process.
The overall concept is to be a learning environment to challenge kids to make good decisions, right?
That's correct. The reason that we're able to do that so effectively is because we operate on a philosophy of experiential learning, which means that we're not simply sitting students down at a table and teaching them a set of principles, but rather we're giving them experience, we're giving them experiences and immersing them in those, and that teaches them skills as they're actually having to use them, which is a far more effective strategy for us in our program.
Yeah, you know, one of the greatest things when you walk into the Challenge Center here at the Kroc Center, you think you're entering a different world, you know, and we really just try and immerse everybody into this situation where you go into a room and a coach will give you a problem or, you know, something that you have to complete, and then there you have to go from there, and you get thrown into a situation where you have to figure it out, and you feel like we have the lights, we have, you know, the rooms all themed, where you feel like you are in a bunker room or, you know, in an underground mine, and it really helps with the learning process.
And like Elise said, as soon as the kids walk into the Kroc Center and they see this building, they see this area, they're like, wow, what's going on? What are we going to do next, you know? And that enthusiasm that they have drives us, you know, and we want to make them more comfortable being here, and we want to make them have so much fun that they have to come back.
Right. So you try to inspire each student?
That's right. It's really about connecting with that individual rather than simply the whole team as a group. And we do that through our mentoring program because we connect each of those students to a mentor. And that connection, along with the connection that the team has to their coach, is really imperative in helping them learn the importance of those three principles.
How do you teach them to make good decisions about problem solving?
We do it mainly through the missions as well as the challenges. And the missions are actually a part of the rescue training format that we use for all of our events. And as I believe I said earlier, we have different challenges that the commandos have to overcome during their training. But then even while commandos are still in training, we deploy them to real world situations as a part of this experience where they have to actually save some people.
So how they really learn to do problem solving is us as coaches don't necessarily do anything. They have to work together as a team. We'll give them a situation and sometimes they'll realize they're starting to fail their mission and they have to turn it around without actually us teaching them or telling them anything. They get to learn by themselves, by teaching themselves almost.
And majority of the time, when we don't say anything and we just stand back and let them do everything, they come up with the most amazing ideas. And I'm like, wow, I would have never thought of that. And once you start to give them that push and that edge and they're like, oh, well, we can think of some more stuff. You know, every time we go to a different event, they try to think of more things and different things to do so that they can accomplish this task.
Cool. So let's talk about the Core Fire Rescue missions when we come back.
Hey, kids. Thank you for joining us, and we'll be right back.
The Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz organization has created an exciting and innovative new way to reach out to the kids in our communities.
The KDPT show is designed to highlight kids in a positive way. The show focuses on education, arts, academics, sports, and music.
We want to strengthen our city and communities with positive energy from our youth.
Through the Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz TV show, we can encourage thousands of kids to set goals, pursue their dreams, and be the best they can be.
The Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz organization is a local 501c3 nonprofit organization benefiting kids ages 5 to 17. We are asking business leaders, school officials, youth organizations, parents, and most of all, kids to get involved and partner with the Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz organization. Your sponsorship and donations are welcome to benefit the ongoing efforts of this program. For more information on sponsorship and or donations, please go to our website at kdptshow.com. Thank you.
Welcome back, kids. We are back with our special guest from the Core Fire Training Zone.
Tell us about the Core Fire Rescue Mission and Rescue Training.
Rescue Training is a really exciting event that we do, again, with a variety of different participants from various age groups, and it includes both the training that you need as a commando to search and rescue for folks, but it's also an opportunity for us to actually deploy our commandos on real missions.
That's great. What kind of skills do the kids need to be a part of the rescue mission?
They don't really have to know anything when they come at first, except that they're going to need to work together as a team, and they're also going to need to bring a positive attitude because we really like everybody to have fun, and we want to keep everybody fired up during our events.
Most definitely. I think our biggest thing is that you definitely come in with a positive attitude, ready to learn, ready to maybe even, you know, make some mistakes and grow as a person, but mainly just be ready to have a lot of fun here.
That's awesome. Do you have to complete rescue training before you can be a Core Fire Commando?
You do, but once you complete rescue training, that automatically makes you a Core Fire Commando.
Okay, thank you.
So why don't you take us through a Core Fire mission?
We'd be delighted to. Let's do it.
Definitely.
Let's go.
Adam, are you ready?
Yeah, Cleveland.
Well, let's go do a Core Fire mission.
All right, guys, so this is our first mission. It is logical linkage, okay? And it's a puzzle we have to put together in a certain order. So the four clues are gonna lead us to the answer to our puzzle. You ready? All right, awesome.
Questions need either black nor blue. Clue number four, the red chip is
red.
Commando, today we got a very important mission that's going to take place. The video is going to show you two towns that have to be flooded. You have to make a critical decision on which town is going to be flooded out.
Some difficult decisions have to be made very quickly.
An amazing learning experience. We want to thank Ty Cobb and his entire staff for allowing us to be here today.
Absolutely, it was our pleasure to have you, and come back anytime. We do, again, a variety of events for all different age groups, so come out with your birthday party, with your school group. We'd love to have you.
Yeah, definitely. As coaches, we can't wait to see you guys out here at the Kroc or at our Cordova location soon.
Bring that positive energy. We'd love to have you.
Kids, you too can become a Core Fire Commando. These activities provide you with the learning skills and motivation you need for everyday life. If you would like to be a part of the Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz show, all you have to do is go to kdptshow.com for more information.
This is Ty Cobb, founder of the Have a Standard Foundation. We'd like to thank Kidz Do Pozitive Thingz for allowing us to be part of their show today. It is a great thing to have a TV show here locally in Memphis that focuses on the great things that kids do here in Memphis. We'd like to encourage you to find out more about the programs we have here at the Kroc Center, also in our location in Cordova. We do camps, after school programs, and it's all done under an environment of to get kids fired up, to get kids from different neighborhoods working together, to get and really to focus on the positive attitude with kids. We have some unique opportunities through our events to have some experiential learning that's not typically done in a community center. And the thing I think that the students enjoy the most is just the relationship with the coaches here. You got a fired up bunch of students that are high school, college students, and even some young adults that are the trainers out here, and they love to work with students and train them and create an environment that's positive, encouraging, and at the same time educational. When the students go through missions here, they have to solve problems, break codes, and it's all done, you know, following a script that's also a mission. The students don't realize that they're actually learning math, science, and problem-solving skills, and even how to work together. So we encourage you to come out, find out more about it, and thank you for this time.
I'm Adam Miles, and on this episode of Kids Tuned Up, I want to talk to you about the blues. Now, the blues primarily started in northern Mississippi. That's where people began singing and playing about their troubles, like hardships, loss of love, work, and religion. People all around could relate their own problems to the blues, and it made it spread like wildfire all around to places like Memphis, Tennessee, the blues capital of the world, Chicago, and Texas. And from there, it went all over the world. And from blues evolved rock and roll. Now today, I want to show you a few techniques that I use in my blues playing that you can use in your blues playing. First of which is the bend. Let's say I want to play this note, the G sharp. But just playing that regular old note sounds kind of bland, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start on the G and bend down till I get to a G sharp. Just like that. Now another thing I like to do when I play the blues is actually tune this top E string down to a D, like this. What this allows me to do is get a nice, deep bass line. That is, if I don't have a bass player playing with me. I can get a sound like this. And last but not least, I want to talk about something that's very similar to a bend, except it's not called a bend, it's called a vibrato. And you put your finger on the note and shake your wrist back and forth. Rather than going up and down like a bend, you just go back and forth. And you don't want to move your whole arm, because that's bad technique. You just use your whole wrist area. That's it. I use all these techniques in my blues playing. Now I'm going to put all this together and show you what you can do. That's it. I'll see you next time on Kidz Tuned Up with Adam Miles. Bye.
Hey kids, we want to thank you for watching the show. As you can see, we're having a lot of fun.
Yes, we are.
Adam, I got a joke for you.
What's the joke?
Alright, so what do you call a snowman with a suntan?
I don't know. What do you call a snowman with a suntan?
A puddle. Alright, so I got another one. Okay. So what's the difference between a guitar and a fish?
I don't know.
You can't tune a fish.
Nah.
Like tune and tuna? Yeah.
Oh! Tuna.
Yeah, like tuna fish.
Okay.
And you can't tune a fish.
Okay.
Yeah. So do you have any jokes?
Yes, I do. I got one about a cookie. Okay.
Cool, what is it?
Why did the cookie go to the
doctor? Alright, so what is it?
Why did the cookie go to the doctor?
I don't know. Why did the cookie go to the doctor?
He felt crummy.
Oh, I get it. Like, yeah. He felt crummy because he's a cookie.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
I also got one about a barber.
Barbers?
Mm-hmm.
That's cool.
Yeah, I know.
Alright, so what is
it? Why did the barber win the race?
I don't know. Why did the barber win the race?
He knew a shortcut.
Shortcut?
Cut.
Like hair? Shortcut? Like he knew a cut.
Shortcut. So he...
Gotcha. That's cool. Okay. Well, kids, we want to thank you for watching the show. For more information, you can go to kdptshow.com. We are welcoming back to our show one of our favorite guests today, a true rising kid artist from Memphis, Tennessee, Demetrius Dawson, better known as D3. D3, thank you for coming out.
Thank you for having me.
Well, we really like your music.
Thank you.
And I think you are a very good dancer and rapper.
Thank you very much.
So why'd you choose to be an inspirational artist versus a secular artist?
Well, I chose to be an inspirational artist because God has given me a gift and I want to give it back to Him with music that pleases Him.
Cool.
Yeah.
So do you write your own songs?
Well, it's me, my uncle, and also my mother.
Who are some people that you have performed with?
I have performed with Canton Jones, Mr. Dale, Mindy's Behavior, and also Jacob Lattimore, and it's just a few.
Just a few?
Yes.
So let's look at some footage on D3. 12-year-old inspirational rapper, dancer, and actor, Demetrius Dawson, better known by his stage name of D3, has been performing since the age of 7. He is known for his smooth footwork, creative dance style, and his lyrical flow. D3 states, "I love being able to perform on stage. It makes me happy to be able to share my gifts with others." Audiences felt the passion from D3 as he performed for various events, ranging from church fundraisers and charity events. D3 released a single entitled Super that created a buzz across the states. D3 not only loves to perform on stage, but he also loves to act and model as well. D3 currently has an album release that is entitled Who Am I? And is now in the studio working on his sophomore project entitled Incomplete. As you can see, this kid is on the move and taking the world over by storm. He is very passionate about the gifts that God has blessed him with. So be on the lookout for D3 in the city around you. Kids, we are still on the set with D3.
So, D3, what do you like doing other than rapping or performing?
Well, other than rapping and performing, I love playing basketball, riding my bike, and also acting as well.
Well, I like playing basketball too.
Well, we're going to have to go against
you. Well, I have to play, so.
Yeah, okay. How did you come up with your stage name?
I came up with my stage name, D3, by the initials in my name, which is Demetrius Datian Dotson, so it has three D's.
Three D's, so yeah. Okay, I got it. So where can your supporters reach out to you, like on social media?
You can follow me on Twitter, HipHopD3, check out my website, www.hiphopd3.com, and you can also look me up on Facebook, HipHopD3 as well.
Cool. So when will your new album be released?
It shall be released in April, and it's entitled Incomplete.
Cool. Where can your music be purchased?
It can be purchased on CD Baby, Amazon, iTunes, and more.
What message do you want to leave with your youth and supporters?
I want to leave with them, if you keep God first, you will never be last, and don't stop dreaming, because it can come true.
Awesome. Thank you for being a part of the set today.
Thank you for having me again.
And we really look forward to your new releases.
Thank you.
For more information on D3, you can go to www.hiphopd3.com.
What's up, y'all? This your boy D3. I'm an actor, inspirational rapper, and also a dancer as well. And I want to let you know, if you keep God first, you will never be last. I'm D3, and kids do positive things.
Well, that's our show for today. Elijah and I would like to thank you for joining us. We also want to thank all of our guests.
Have you found that DVD yet? Hurry and send it in.
Remember, you are an amazing kid. Just dream big. We can change the world. Just be a positive kid. Oh, and don't forget, kids do positive things.